Moving real quickly now, we have two scripture readings. I want to call Mumu to prepare and also Kendagaano. You can make your way to the pulpit over there. The first reading.
Hello, everybody. I'll be reading from Isaiah chapter 19, verses 19 to 25. In that day, there will be an altar to the Lord in the heart of Africa, and a monument to the Lord at its border. It will be a sign and a witness to the Lord Almighty in the land of Africa. When they cry out to the Lord because of their oppressors, he will send them a savior and a defender. He will rescue them. So the Lord will make himself known, and he will rescue them. To the Africans. And in that day, they will acknowledge the Lord. They will worship with sacrifices and grain offerings. They will make vows to the Lord and keep them. The Lord will strike Africa with a plague. He will strike them and heal them. They will turn to the Lord, and he will respond to their pleas and heal them. In that day, there will be a highway from Africa to Assyria. The Assyrians will go to Africa, and the Africans to Assyria. The Africans and Assyrians will worship together. In that day, Israel will be the third, along with Africa and Assyria. A blessing on the earth. The Lord Almighty will bless all three, saying, "Blessed be Africa, my people, Assyria, my handiwork, and Israel, my inheritance."
The second reading is from Romans 8, verse 28 to 37. And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. For those God foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. Those he called, he also justified. Those he justified, he also glorified. What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us.
A big hand clap to those young people. Thank you very much for the scripture readings, and thank you for keeping the legacy of the family.